with allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. We have amended the agenda, so I need a motion to approve the amended agenda.
I move that we approve the amended agenda.
Second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carried, the agenda is approved. Have discussion of the open council position with the council and council members. Ken Ware has presented us a letter, a very good letter, that he's interested in joining the council. Ken was a council member when I first joined the council and stayed that way until he had to change jobs and leave in 2014. So he's a very good council member, and I'd like to have a motion to approve Ken Ware as our new council member.
I'll make a motion. Approve him as a council member.
Have a motion?
Second that.
Have a motion and a second to approve Ken for council. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion is approved.
Okay.
Council, would you, or Ken, would you come up, please?
Oath of office here.
Take your oath of office and have a seat.
Here, there, everywhere.
Just waiting first.
So, State of Washington, Snohomish County, aye.
Aye. Ken Ware.
Do solemnly swear to affirm that I will support the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of the State of Washington, and that I will faithfully and impartially perform and discharge the duties of the office of council member, City of Gilboa, for an appointed term according to the best of my ability.
Welcome back. Thank you, Ken, and welcome back.
Okay.
Up to you.
Mayor's report. There was an AWC meeting in Granite Falls on the 12th of April. Dinner served between 5 and 6. Meeting is between 6 and 8 for, it's mainly for new council members. If you can make it to Granite Falls by 6 o'clock, it'd be a good thing to go to. It's kind of hard for working people to make it up there by 6. Meeting is from 6 to 8, and it has a lot of good information. Same thing we've been through it already, Ken.
That's a Tuesday. Okay.
It's in the City Hall in Granite Falls.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That'd be next week.
Yeah, the 12th.
Okay.
I'll go, but I can't get out of town for that long a time at once, so.
I'll probably go. I'm available on Tuesday, so.
Yeah, it'd be great. It'd be great. Baby's already got the plan, so she won't be there. So.
That's at the City Hall?
Yeah, City Hall in Granite Falls. They're going to have dinner from 5 till 6. I'll go over the... Denise can get you going on the computer, and there's a place up there that's... you can reserve a spot so they have a head count for dinner. Let's see, I don't have anything else with mayor's report. Staff report? Casey?
So the last meeting, I had announced that Emil was still in custody for burglaries, and I was wrong. He'd been released a few days prior to that, and I wasn't aware. And so, but since then, we had a report of a vehicle prowl where property was stolen and then sold to another subject, and we traced that back to him and picked him up and booked him into Snohomish County Jail on that. And also, he had warrants for failing to appear in court after being released on his own recognizance. So he's back in custody, still currently charged with 2 counts of residential burglary, and I don't see yet a docket number where charges have been filed on the new felony charge of trafficking stolen property, but that may come. So, but he's currently in custody. I've confirmed that on a public website. I've put the web address on a sheet of paper back there. That's open to anybody in the room that wants to look up who's in jail or who's been booked, that sort of thing. I confirmed on that website right before council meeting that he is still in custody on $10,000 bail.
Thank you.
We had the incident last week with multiple hit and runs on 8th and 9th Street in Timber Lane. And that subject was not booked. The juvenile detention center being funded by grants, in order to qualify for that grant funding, when they built that thing, they had to create booking criteria that matched the state and federal guidelines. And so for juveniles to just book them in jail, they have to meet those criteria, and he did not at the time. So we were not able to book him into juvenile detention that night. We did forward a charging request to the prosecutor asking him to review the case and consider filing charges for multiple counts of hit and run and for reckless driving. So the young man was cooperating with us when we dealt with him. I think that was probably a reasonable action given that he's a juvenile. That's how that was handled. The other reports that I have in the sheet here aren't anything really critical. Last meeting I introduced Deputy Stuart Gart. I put that in the notes here again, just so that anybody who missed last week can see that we have Deputy Stuart Gart has replaced Deputy Jason Sand here. So,
okay.
That's it.
Thank you. Denise, do you have anything?
Yes, so I attended the farmer's market this past weekend on Sunday. It looked to be going rather well. That was a good turnout, I believe, and I hope to see more of it. And other than that, I don't really have any other staff reports.
So, tell me how the farmer's market.
So the resident has gotten put together a farmer's market, and so she's trying to get vendors. So it's
in Gold Bar,
it's on Orchard Avenue in the park there. So there was, you know, Fancy Fronds was there with some plants. There was, you know, people with artwork, and they cut flowers, so they hope to expand that and get more vendors, and it'll be on Sundays. From, I believe, 9 to 2. If you'd like more information on that, I have applications up at the
okay.
Blueberry season. If you can.
Oh, yeah.
Now, I forgot about going Sunday. I wish I hadn't forgot. They had a lot of plants for gardens and stuff to sell there, and a lot of tulips that was cut to make bouquets. So I forgot about it, and I missed out. Council comments? Brian?
Nothing at this time.
Okay. Davey?
Well, I was busy last week. On Monday, I went to Index. They had a tourism seminar, and the subject was outdoor adventures, and it was inspiring. little intimidating. There's a lot of possibilities and there's a lot of work to do. But it's going to spark a lot of discussion and a lot of forward thinking. So, and there will be more seminars. Unfortunately, the next one is the 12th, and I'm flying to Phoenix to see a granddaughter. And sorry, but that trumps it. And then there's two more that I'll be going to.
Okay, thank you. And you're welcome, Ken.
Welcome, Ken.
Do you have anything to add, Ken? Citizens' comments. Have anything that's not on the agenda you'd like to chew me out for? Okay, well, nice to meet you.
Hanging in my truck.
Yeah.
Where is it?
Our new business. Resolution. 1601. That's the, this is to set a finance committee. And it's something that we've always done, but it's never been on paper. And so we felt that it should be a resolution in case we do get questions on it. It's a matter of two council members and two citizens. I need a motion to approve that resolution.
I move that we approve resolution number 16-01.
I'll second it.
Okay, I have a question though.
Discussion?
Discussion, yes. Meeting date and time. It says here that the finance committee meets weekly. I thought it meant bi-weekly.
It's just before every council meeting.
Okay, so it's a bi-weekly
yes.
meeting. So we need to...
I'll have Lisa change that. Okay.
So I don't have a copy of what you need.
Sorry. Oh, here, you know what? We have your very own packet.
Yay!
We probably should set this aside till next meeting. And we'll put bi-weekly in there. So we'll table that until next.
So the reason for tabling?
There's a correction.
Need a motion to table it, Joel.
There's a correction on the meeting date and time.
Is that limit approval?
Pardon?
No, you could make a motion to approve it with that addition.
That's so what I'm asking.
Yes, you could move to approve it with that addition.
Yeah, could we have a motion to approve it with the addition?
I'll make a motion to approve it with the addition.
Okay, a second?
I'll second it.
Motion made, a second. Any discussion further?
There's another typo in it. Another typo?
Oh,
you got something, Brian?
Be resolved by the governing body of the city of Gold Bars that policies, sets policies, establishes policies. I think there's a word missing. That's all. Just another minor correction.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
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 Thank you. We have resolution 1602. This is for, we passed a resolution increasing the water rates. And for some of the seniors, This has been a pretty good of a hard line for them to accomplish, so I would like to counsel to consider, instead of having to pay $32 on the assessment rate for seniors, for not all seniors, but for seniors that meets the
low income
class, have them pay $15.41 rather than $32.
So should it just say low income instead of senior citizens?
I agree.
Well, yeah, just low income.
Just low income.
Probably does say that here.
It actually says elderly. I think that should be removed.
I don't know, we're in discussion, but on that particular point, I think you should qualify low income as well, because, I mean, when I read this, I don't know what low income means.
Low income, the city has a low income qualification now.
Understand now.
Yeah.
But as I read this, I didn't understand, so I believe it should be written in there, that standard, whatever that standard is.
Okay. That's probably a good idea. I don't know offhand what that is, so Denise will have to look that up.
The standard, so you have to be 55 years of age.
We don't want the details of the standard, but we want to reference the standard.
It is.
Okay.
Yeah, this happened, we'll
Presume it's written.
Get a motion to table this until the 19th of April, and we'll bring it back.
Written correctly, yeah.
Yeah. We'll bring in a corrected copy.
So we were going to yes or no on the, elderly. So are we going to strike the senior? One of you said that you wanted to strike the senior.
I would like to strike the senior part of it. It should just be based on income, not age.
Just age, it'll be changed.
Is there going to be low income?
Low income.
No matter how old, okay.
Yeah, we'll have a motion to table this until the 19th of April.
A motion to table it till the 19th.
I second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Thank you, Ken. Resolution 1603, transportation. This is a every 6 year thing. It's just a formality that we need to approve. And John will send it to the proper places. This resolution the city has to approve every year, and it's a 6 year resolution, but it needs to be approved every year. I have a motion to approve resolution 1603.
I move that we approve resolution 1603, the Transportation Improvement Board Agreement.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Does anybody want to discuss it?
Can we add something?
Can we add something?
Well, we need a sign on First Avenue. Have you noticed on First Avenue there's no proper sign? I mean, somebody put up a really nice looking duplicate sign, but there's no proper sign there. It goes second, all the way up to 10th, and this is on
something
sign.
That you'd want to add to this.
Okay.
So this is, my question was, this is basically unrevised. It was approved previous, like last year and the year before, and it's in an unrevised state, so we're just basically...
Just renewing it every year. It's, I don't think it's been revised since you was here, really.
This is a resolution and not a plan. This is, I'm trying to, maybe I should ask what's the purpose of this too, so I get a full grasp of what I'm approving here before I actually
say. Yeah, this is a resolution. It's not an ordinance.
There's no funding in here, there's no nothing.
No. This list, list of projects that the city has in mind to do it for the next 6 years.
Okay.
Doesn't mean that we have to do these projects, but it means...
No.
These are projects that's listed that we can ask for grants.
Correct.
So any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, a credit and debit reader discussion. Now, this is so Denise or anybody working in the office can accept credit cards or debit cards for the payments of water bills, whatever bills that stormwater, recycling, whatever they bring in, and Denise will be able to accept a credit card or a debit card. We're probably one of the few people in the country that don't, not able to accept credit cards and debit cards, so this will make things a lot easier for the girls in the office. There is a charge to it. I think I read someplace where it's $25 a month. What was it, Denise?
So, I don't know that it's $25 a month. I think that was the automatic deposits. So, on the front page, it talks about percentages for different cards, and then the 20 cents. Down below, you'll see monthly service fee of $10. Monthly PCI compliance fee is $9.50. Annual regulatory product fee $36, billed in September.
So my understanding, to be clear, is that these discount rates and monthly fees are the fees charged to the customer. The monthly service fee, the PCI compliance fee, and any regulatory product are charged to the city of Gold Bar.
Yeah, and then we'd have to buy this machine in order to put it on there, $350 for this. For that little machine.
So on that, Ken, I can't answer that as far as that's going to be billed to us or if that's going to go to the customer. I would believe that it would go to the customer, but I will find out for sure.
Well, somebody's going to pay the city of, or the Coastal Community Bank these
right.
fees.
Right.
And whether we pass them on to the customer or not, this is the fee for that service.
Correct.
That's my point. And I believe that we can do it.
I don't think you can pass it on to the customer.
No, because I think the rates are set here. They've already told us what they're going to charge for using those cards.
Yeah, and then that's the same thing if you use a credit card anywhere else. They don't pass that on to the customer.
Well, they do.
Oftentimes, it depends on the size of the
monthly fee that would be the city of Gold Bar paying away. My question is, would we, any other institutions, for see if they're in around the same ballpark, right? With the same fees.
So we get lots of emails from different vendors that want to sell us their equipment.
Right.
I like this one because it's our bank. So I feel a little bit secure with that, the Coastal Community. I can most certainly look for other vendors.
Okay, so that was the only one we did.
This is one that actually came to the office and talked to us. And again, they're with our bank.
Yeah, this is just a discussion for you to go home and think about, and then we'll bring it up for action probably on the 19th of April.
So to follow with what you were saying is, and I think I understand you, but just to be clear, that I don't think these rates differ from, I think this is Coastal Community Bank's rate, and every customer that they have pays the same rate. That's the way I would read it.
Right. That's the way I would say that too,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
If I can make a recommendation, the county uses them and the county does pass the fee on. So that might be one place to start to get an idea of what Gold Bar might want to do to pass the fees on to the customer for the convenience of being able to use that card. slightly more than that 20% of the transaction or whatever. It's a set amount typically, but it, that helps the county also cover the cost of the equipment and the annual fees that they're having to pay, so that the net loss to the county hopefully is zero. And so that, I would recommend that you explore that either with the county or with other cities that have this in place.
And other cities do what?
Where they charge a set fee for using the card that also helps absorb the cost of having to buy the equipment and having to pay annual maintenance fees for that contract with your bank. So it, you talk to the neighboring cities and the county about what seems to be a good fee or a good assessment that would cover this cost, and hopefully they can help you work through that so that you're, so the city of Gold Bar isn't suffering a loss for the cost. And of course, the person who's paying their bill, if they don't want to pay the fee, always has the option to pay cash or write a check. So.
Mm-hmm. Okay, any further discussion on this? Anybody?
Excuse me, Lee. I might be able to add a little something to it since I kind of run a lot of credit cards. But my name's Stephen Four. I own Alpine Adventures, and I bank with the community bank to myself. Rates that he's has here are actually pretty comparable to what I pay for my business, and you're allowed to recoup. I suggest adding on, because you are allowed to add on to collect your money back by law, so it doesn't cost you anything. And generally what everybody's paying is, and if they're giving you the rates on cards, the only difficulty I would see in what you have for the rates here is whether or not how Denise is going to know how the card qualifies, because she needs to be to know what to charge for that percentage. So you might want to try some other venues, such as ones the sheriff can lead us to, that have just a set amount, because otherwise Denise, it depends on the card they're handing you. Mm-hmm. And if they're handing you an American Express card, I don't even recommend taking them. But Visa and MasterCard, you can get on any of them three different rates on just on how the card's qualified, whether they, whether you get to enter the three digit, how they process it. It's there's a lot of tangibles and variables in there.
So it's not an automatic?
It's not an automatic. As it says here, it's qualified cards, mid-qualified cards, and non-qualified cards. So the difficulty that I saw is it might make it a nightmare for you to know exactly what to charge a person at the point of sale. Does that make sense?
It does. Yes.
Yeah. That would be my other, but as far as recouping your credit cards and getting your money back, you definitely are allowed by law to do that.
Thank you.
That's it.
Thank you.
Actually not a bad rate.
Okay, our last thing on the agenda is cleaning of the upper tank. CVD feasibilities. Kendra wanted this on the agenda to discuss it. Whether we still want to have a feasibility study or not.
Well, we never did officially.
Yeah, we never did say yes or no.
We never did say yes or no, sir. Actually, every person I've talked to outside of people that have come here to testify, yeah, not one person has been in favor of going to PUB that I've talked to. I wish it would be a larger swath of the 600, 700 something people that are being affected. I'm one of them being affected with the fees as well. Like one council member said at one of a couple of meetings I came for before I swore in, nobody shows up. I thought for sure that we would have, especially once the fees hit and the first bill's gone out, which it has, that I get more people in here arguing for the PUD feasibility study. Everybody I've talked to outside of here has said no, they want to keep water inside the city of Gold Bar. I just wanted to put that out there that say it affects me just like it does everybody else here. So, does anybody else have anything?
Do we want a feasibility study, or do we just want to city council?
Well, that is the technical.
Can't hear you.
Sorry. Yeah. Did we want him to invite the man
here for a city council meeting, or do we actually want the proper free feasibility study?
Well, that was the question, yeah. I mean, it is the same thing, from what I understand. If he comes out, he's doing the first part of the feasibility study. That part is free.
I didn't realize they were one and the same. I thought it'd be similar to what happened when the USDA representative came out.
No, it sounds like from what his email back to you and some of the questions, and what he has said in the past, is at this point, he would want to invite from the council, I think, to not have his feet in the fire, so to speak, from people that are angry at the direction.
No, I think he's answered about all the questions that to take of, so I don't see where he'd be at advantage to have him come out here, but if council wants to have him, invite him out, we can certainly do that. Or if we wanted to do away with this feasibility thing and go on with something else, we can do that.
The way I've read this is that he's not just gonna come out to a meeting. No, but it's, the way I took it from speaking with him on the phone was that they would start the process of actually doing the feasibility study. He's not just gonna come sit and be, it sounded like when I spoke with him a month or so ago, I don't know what was going on today, but he made it very clear to me that the city would be behind it. There'll be a letter wanting him to come out. He's not gonna come sit and just talk, and even then he wouldn't be able to answer your questions, he said, most likely.
No. He says, to date, I have not received a request from the city of Gold Bar to attend any of your public meetings to be presented back. He's just like, we need anybody.
Written from the city council is what he told me at that point.
But actually, we have, we got to go forward with our water department, and eventually we'll do, like on the council meeting on the 19th, I'll be bringing up to the city council for a scrubber for well four to get rid of the arsenic. My notion, if we get rid of the arsenic in well four, we won't have to take a back seat to anybody for water. Our water will be as good as PUDs, and we don't have to pay for a feasibility study. And we have just passed an assessment on our water for $20. We need a project for that. I think we could call USDA and see if we can't get a scrubber financed and get moving on that as fast as possible. Get it installed, get our clean water. It also, it takes out everything, takes out arsenic along with any other impurities that might be in there. So it's something that we need on well four anyway. That well four is a deep well. Deep wells have arsenic. And the history of deep wells, I've been researching this for the last couple of weeks. Deep wells get worse over years, take years, but they get worse. So we need a scrubber on well four. We've got millions of dollars invested into well four. It's got a beautiful setup there, so we might as well go ahead and make it a better setup and give Gold Bar as good a healthy water as you can buy in the country. We'll bring that up on the 19th of April for all of you people, all the council members can do research of yourself on that. And by the 19th of April, I'd like to get that going. Get in contact. In fact, I can get in contact with USDA this week sometime, and maybe find out what her information would be as to just exactly how fast we can go about that. Because with the assessment that we've already made with the citizens, we will be able to pay back a loan now that would require. In 2021, on the water comp plan, that was listed as $500,000. Now that was for 2021, so if we get that, if we get it right away, we might be able to save $100,000 or something. A bigger labor will go up about 20% a year. So by getting it now, we could get good healthy water. We wouldn't have to call on PUD or anybody else, and we would be in a position to expand our water system. And no reason to not have good healthy water. That's my take on it. If we want to have a motion to do away with the feasibility study, or if we want to have a motion to continue it, entertain a motion one way or the other.
I'll make a motion to do away with it.
Have a motion to drop feasibility study. Do you have a second?
Second that.
Discussion?
So, I heard you say pay for a feasibility study or feasibility study for free. I don't know where we've been. There's no interest in, from what I heard over here, there's no interest in a feasibility study anyway. So I'm not really
interested. Just from the small amount of people that I've talked to.
Not really interested in pursuing it. But it may be an option that we would have to reconsider at some point.
I suppose you could consider a feasibility study from PUD anytime you invite them.
Right, but the point
is... But the feasibility study that they do the first time is nothing but checking with the records of the city.
So I haven't been here for 18 months, 19 months, 20 months, whatever. So I don't really know the status of our water program, whether it's profitable, whether it's not profitable. We were kind of on edge last time I was here. And that's really what I'm thinking long range, but at the same time, everybody seems to be satisfied with the status quo. So I'm willing to accept the status quo for at least a year or two until it does become a problem, and then we can come back and revisit it. That's my point. Yeah. I don't think that we need to pursue it at this point. I think I'm in favor of maybe doing away with it or tabling it for the moment. But I'm leaving my options open should things change, because we don't know what financially how I don't know financially how we're set.
Mm-hmm. Okay, any other discussion? Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any objections?
Nay.
Motion is carried. Okay, now we can get to the cleaning of the tank on the upper water tank. It needs to be cleaned every 5 years, and we're a little bit behind time on that. And Richard got us an estimate of $3,500. From this company to come out, put their sterile suits on and scuba deer and go down there and underwater vacuum the tank. Takes about 6 to 8 hours, I guess, to do that.
And this tank is at well four?
Pardon?
This tank is at well four?
No, this is on the upper.
It's the big
up, tank way up on the hill.
Okay.
Well four was cleaned, I think, a couple of years ago. This is supposed to be done every 5 years. I think we've done about 5 years and 6 months or those, but so it needs to be done for purification reasons.
Is that in line with what we've paid before?
That's actually cheaper. Quite a bit cheaper than what we paid before. I don't know why, but this is the bid that we got. So.
This name sounds really familiar. Are they the people that did the work on well four?
Yeah, they've done a lot of work on well. Yeah. They're usually good.
So we're happy with you.
We did clean our well.
Yeah, John, John wasn't able to hear tonight, but he said that he likes his company, that they do good work.
Good.
I'll make a motion to accept it.
Okay, make
I'll second that motion.
Any discussion? Okay. Motion's made and second to give John the authority to contract with this company for cleaning of the upper well. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion's passed. Final council comments. Anybody, any council have any more comments that we missed the first time? Brian?
On any topic?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I wanted to answer Steve's question from last time. You added the two concentrations together and you got 11.7 micrograms, right? Right, but that's in 2 liters. You have to divide by 2, which is 5.85 micrograms per liter.
Okay.
So it's always been in compliance. However, I happen to agree with you that it should be lower, and Mayor Hoda has already addressed that.
Kendall?
No, sir.
Maybe? Ken?
No, it's, I don't know what this could be.
Can I respond to that since I was addressed?
Sure.
Yes. The math on all this gets questioned around a lot of different directions, but there's documentation that's going to be presented, and the amount of inorganic arsenic that is recommended for a human body is absolutely flat zero. Our water is being tested for arsenic, and it's being tested for arsenic because we meet the requirements by law that says you have to test, and that's at 0.3, correct? 0.003, right? That's what it's on there. And what we're testing at is above that, is twice that. And then if you do the math, it does put it up over. And I do not think that everybody at the EPA, Department of Health, and everybody else is wrong.
Okay, excuse me.
Actually,
we're still in a council meeting here. I didn't call for citizens.
Well, I was addressed, though.
I did address. I'm sorry.
I mean,
you can have your comments when we call for citizens' comments. Have the minutes approval. Everybody read the minutes?
Motion to approve the minutes from 3/15/16.
Okay. Do I have a second?
Second, yep.
Any discussion? Okay, minutes are approved.
We got a vote?
We got a vote.
Oh, everybody, all favor, all favor.
Aye.
Absolutely.
Doctor approval. Davey?
All right. I approve the checks number 31273 through 31310 for a total of $38,390.76, of which claims are $23,279.11. Payroll is $15,111.65.
Give it a second.
Second.
Have a motion made and second. Any discussion on the vouchers? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Vouchers are approved. Okay, Steve, citizens' comments.
How do you know I'd want to go first? Actually, I'm going to defer to certain water things to somebody who's actually dug up a lot of information, including studies done by Oxford University.
We've got 3 minutes, so you can get
so.
You did not have 3 minutes.
Since we're getting to 11 o'clock. The one thing tonight that I saw wasn't a positive thing, because I definitely saw more positive stuff. Really appreciate you coming back. I like the way you do thoroughness. I like that you actually got to go to a meeting that I'd like to have gone, but I didn't go because Corson's a competing company that don't get along with anybody, so a lot of us didn't attend. Brian, I see you walking by all the time going up and down, so, and Kendall, I hear about you digging up information on stuff, and I kind of like that. That's a good thing. Lee, lovely, is a positive thing. One thing I didn't like, and it really cost us nothing to do it, the people that were actually here and did homework and came out to the meetings and actually were clear and transparent standing here all said feasibility study, let's just do it, let's just get it done. It doesn't cost us a penny to do it. But we came back and people that, we don't know what research they did, and I know that you did speak with other people and stuff, but they weren't the people that took the time to come down here and speak to the council and use their 3 minutes. But the people that did and attended all the different stuff, they just want to hear it. And there's a reason why we want to hear it. A lot of us seriously question the actions of one particular person that works for the city. We think the water comp plan is not acceptable. We think that our water quality is not acceptable. And I bet you we have a lot of documentation and stuff that presents it that says that it's not good for us. Well, we're going to try to remove one part with a scrubber, but why don't we just make everything clear and transparent? Let the people have their feasibility study. It doesn't cost the city of Gold Bar one penny to send something in and have it done. And then every person that stood in here, spent the time to come here, sees that you actually did what they asked, we will have people in the seat. But people come to me and go, why go to a council meeting? They're just going to do what they want anyway. And then they do because they were sitting here, said, we want this, and they got told no. Why are they going to want to come? I mean, that's really, really simple. The people standing here get blown off. They're not going to come back. And that's a shame because the more people you have helping out in the community, the stronger the community.
Anybody else?
Julian Price, 307 Grant. I have a question. How many tanks are we using? Water tanks?
Two.
And are they both in need of cleaning?
No.
Okay. The other thing is, the last time I asked you for some leeway on the water monies for people who want gardens. I want a garden. I've gardened for years. And I can't afford to garden at the rate that you have now. Not the money, but the amount of water. It's ridiculous. 6,000 gallons is not enough. That's not enough if you don't garden. Have you even talked about it? Thought about it?
Actually, yes. Yes.
Well, then why didn't you say something about it?
Yeah, it has been discussed.
Yeah.
And are we going to get turned down, like a lot of times?
As far as I know, it's never been anybody's never suggested, the council member has not suggested the changes. So
I know
you are turned down as of now.
We're turned down at 6,000 gallons.
Still the same 6,000 gallons.
No wonder people don't come to these meetings. My God.
If you go over your 6,000, they don't shut your water off. They charge you.
They charge it the hell out of it.
I think that this is something that, in our council discussion, Joanne, we had kind of decided to see where it went and how the usage has gone, and it's not written in stone. We can change it.
Well, gardening season has really started. By the first of May, things will be in the ground. So how long are you going to wait?
Well, we can certainly bring it up. We can certainly put it on the agenda for.
But how many times do we have to bring it up? This is twice now, and you're dismissing it out of hand.
I'm going to make a motion to have that on the next agenda for the next council meeting to increase the break points.
Okay. Motion to bring it up on the next agenda for April the 19th for a water discussion, water.
I don't know what to call them. I've been calling them break points. Water usage cutoffs. How about that?
Allowance. Water usage allowance.
Allowance. Sure.
Have a second?
We only have so much generators that we can switch out of room number three. If you pump one or four, we're just increasing.
We need to change to one for ready.
We did. We raised it from five to six.
Five and raise it back to six.
And the six was a couple of ours.
Okay, we have a motion to put the water discussion on the agenda for April 19th. Have a motion and a second. Any discussion further?
Excuse me, Lee.
All in favor?
Excuse me, Lee. Could I add something you might want to add to that?
No, we got a motion going here.
You might want to take consideration over what the levels of water are coming. You only have so much water in well three to mix with well four, which is the higher arsenic water. You're going to raise that arsenic level.
We're not discussing.
And well, as I said, if you raise the water that you give out, you're going to have to make more.
Okay, we'll have that on the agenda for next, for April 19th.
How much do you use a month?
I don't know exactly.
Okay, I need a motion to adjourn.
There's more citizens out here.
There's more citizens.
Oh, okay.
Excuse me, can I ask one question?
Yeah, go ahead.
Only concerning the diameter of the pipe coming in to the, did you guys resolve that or if I missed something on the, I've got a 2-inch pipe and I don't. Okay.
Lee, you have point of order. You have to have point of order.
What's a point of order?
You have a motion on the floor. You cannot.
We passed that. It's all done. We're going to have agenda for the water on the agenda.
Okay, then you have discussion.
Okay, yes, sir. My question about the new assessment process and how it's based depending on the diameter of the pipe supply coming in at the meter. Is that correct? Anybody?
The what?
No. It's not correct.
No. So it's not based on, because I'm getting billed for a 2-inch pipe. Remember, we were talking about 3/4 of 1 inch, sir?
Yeah.
Former Mayor Beavers, yeah. So, and I'm paying for one person for two-inch pipe and getting a lot of money.
I can kind of answer that. So before, and Mountain View Diner isn't here, a lot of the businesses, post office, Mountain View Diner, you, anybody with a 2-inch meter is automatically getting charged $146. If you had a 2-inch meter. Now you're getting charged $33 for that 2-inch meter, but you're still only allowed the 6,000 gallons. So before you were allowed up to 20 or 30,000. And I would again have to look at your history bill.
And that's about what I'm using.
And now you've gone down again, so your meter price has gone down, but you're paying for that usage that you were allowed before.
Okay,
does
so
that make sense?
Yeah, because I've gone from four units or four residences there to only one now.
Right, and your assessment, because you're a multi-family unit, and again, I would have to look at your bill to see how many units you're being charged for. But that's where your assessment would be charged on how many units. So the trailer parks, say the one down at the end of the street, has 116 or 60 sites. And so they're charged per site for their assessment. So their water came down, but their assessment went up.
Mm-hmm. And I understand that. And I know, so I pay about a $210 bill for one person there. And then I have a 16-unit apartment, and I pay $430.
Okay,
so I see that as a disproportionate amount of.
It would be based on your usage. So regardless of how many people you got there, if you've got a leaky pipe or somebody just leaving the faucet running and going over that 6,000 gallons, that's where your $200 bill comes in.
Can I get a new updated meter and diminish, take the two inch down?
You would need to talk to John about that again. And we've discussed this many times about what you would need to do as far as metering your place.
Okay, what is the differential between commercial and residential than in my place?
As far as the rates?
Yeah.
There's commercial, so a normal water bill is $30.90 for water. So I pay $30.90 for water. You pay, I believe, $33-something for water. The assessment is now, instead of the $12.41, it's $20.41. So...
What can I expect? I saw an assessment charge this month, so what can I expect? What's the bottom line that I...
Again, I don't have your bill in front of me. So unless you brought one with you.
Thank you.
But if you want to come in tomorrow, I can go over that with you.
Will do, thank you.
Are you still citizen comments?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I'm shut up here.
Well, usually I follow Ms. Cotterell, so tonight I'll be... 39964 Maker Crow and Chuck Lee. And I'll just take this last opportunity. Kendall, you know, I really appreciate you and Brian being on the council. I'm glad that Ken came back as well. But when you're out talking to neighbors, you know, I found that community polls in this neighborhood really resemble what do you want for dessert, chopped liver or ice cream. And you know people always choose ice cream. I'm probably one of the five people in this city that have actually read the comprehensive plans. And ever since the town meeting here 2 months ago, I still have not received straight answers to the written questions I submitted. And again, I'd like to have those, Lee, because one of the problems I've had ever since I started coming to City Hall was no straight answers. I get something that someone thinks or wants me to believe is a straight answer, and it really isn't. It's somebody's opinion or somebody's spin. So I'm real disappointed here. Roll your eyes, dude. But in the meantime, I'm just a little disappointed that you did not follow through on what the citizens who have taken the time to read and educate themselves on the water system have come and presented their opinions to you. So anyways, thank you guys for being on. I look forward to hopefully the council doing some better action here.
Arsenic and that, but I'm a registered nurse. My A's in anatomy, physiology, and science too. And I've read just about, this is only about a tenth of what I've read. And the one thing I know is, Lee, thank you very much. You've heard me. You've heard me. And the scrubber on the wells to start this project will be get you. I do think the PUD should be allowed to come out and just do the free feasibility study just so that we can hear what they have to say. And really, at the end of that letter that I, the information that I've seen today, I don't know if that's what it is, but once they do it and all of that, it's like a 2-year plan. It's done. The whole system. If you want to do a feasibility study on buying that all back from them, that'd be cool too. But we got to do something so that the people can hear what PUD says they can do and how they can do it and in the time frame they can do it. Please. Now, on top of that, for this thing coming up on the 19th talking about arsenic, I would like to present this stuff. It's all highlighted, everything. And the level that we're getting is bad. This one very much tells you exactly what arsenic does when it goes into your body and the things that it affects, and it doesn't just affect our generation, it affects the next generation, and it affects it at the level we've been getting for years. The level that they have set is a law that they passed a long time ago. It needs to be changed. It's not going to be changed right away, and it's legal to feed us poison right now. And everybody needs to know, I'd like to ask the city to, if they agree after reviewing all my information, to maybe revise in any way they want, but to maybe send one of these out to everybody in the city so that the city can at least be knowledgeable and educate themselves and maybe protect themselves to the level that they want to protect themselves, not what the city's chosen to be done. Please, can I present this to you guys?
Sure.
Thank you, Sharon.
Thank you.
Any other comments?
May I?
Vicki?
Yes. Vicki McDaniel, 504 First Avenue West, Gold Bar. Welcome, council. Welcome back. It's good to see you. I just have a quick question. For the scrubber, if we're looking at a USDA loan for that, then does that mean we're going to have another USDA loan for our infrastructure going in? So that means we're going to have two USDA loans.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I believe what we have one USDA loan out now. So what I'm looking at is reality. Our price is going to go up again.
Well, I don't think so, but you can have as many USDA loans as you're able to pay back.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be able to make the payments. So when the USDA lady was here, she said that you can have as many as you're qualified for.
Mm-hmm.
That has no effect on the USDA loan that we have now. You know, we're eligible for another, to get another loan with this assessment that we just put on.
Mm-hmm.
So, rather than, we can't just keep charging people an extra $20 a month and put the money in the bank. That's not what it was for. It was for infrastructure to help our city.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think my own thinking would be the scrubber would be the number one project.
Mm-hmm.
We already have another project going on 10th Street to replace the water line there.
Mm-hmm.
We're trying at the same time to get maybe a pavement, new pavement done on 10th Street at the same time. We have a grant for the water.
Mm-hmm.
So we're getting these projects going just as fast as we can. It has the amount of loans that we already have with USDA has nothing to do with your new loans.
Okay. I'm all in favor for the scrubber. I think that's a big, huge direction moving forward for our water and for the citizens. Keep our water safe. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So am I allowed to make a comment here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, when I left here, there was already an issue with the arsenic in the wells, and we were already a bit debating at that point whether the city should maintain control over the water system or whether we should look to PUD. And so, having listened to the citizens here tonight, I think I've had a reversal already on my opinion, which, by the way, I never came in and said that I wanted to postpone, but I think we really need to do that feasibility. I really, that's where I've changed my mind, because rather than allow you guys to tell me that nobody has an interest, I think I've heard otherwise here. So I think we really ought to consider doing a feasibility study, just so we know where we're at.
Well, I see no reason why we can't, while council is here, council meeting was, the agenda was really over, but we can go back. I don't see any reason why we can't go back while council is here to get a motion to invite Mr. Wood out here. And that doesn't necessarily mean that we're inviting him for a feasibility study. We can invite for a feasibility study without having him come out and address the public.
Right, and I don't know that inviting him out here is really what anybody's asked for. I think what people have asked for, because as I understand it, the feasibility study is free of charge.
The first feasibility is nothing but checking the city records.
Yeah.
That's all it does. They come into the office and ask John all the questions about them, look at the map where the lines are. They look at city records of what size the lines they are, what, you know, the course, there's a lot of old lines in this town that the city has no as-built on. But that's all they do on the first piece of building station, which is free to the city. They take that information back, PUD, and then they give it to the commissioners. And the commissioners say, well, it wouldn't be feasible to go ahead and go in with Goldwater this time. Or they can say, well, we could go ahead and do a second feasibility, which is $30,000 that the city has to pay for. So at that time, the city would have to have an assessment on the water bill to pay for the $30,000. A one-time assessment to pay for $30,000 would be about $40 a month.
One correction, Lee, there. The $30,000 might actually be paid for by a grant.
A grant is possible.
That's a possibility.
That's not guaranteed, so you might as well forget about the grant part.
Well, they already, the deadline for the grants complete was February.
PUD gets their water from, gets their loans from the Department of Water and the state, which they don't give grants or any loans after the end of March. So that's part of that. And of course, they could ask for a grant, but if they don't get the grant, then the city has to pay $30,000. Now, that's the second feasibility.
But all we want to do is ask questions. Just ask somebody from BUD questions.
I don't even know if it's questions so much as...
Well, if you read that letter there that we got from PUD...
But he's not here. He's not here.
But a feasibility study done by engineers that do this on a regular basis rather than a company that says, oh, if you
We're going back into council now. Let's knock out the comments. Mm-hmm. So does council want to have a feasibility, have the man come out and talk to the public, or have a feasibility study? What does council want? What's the motion?
Well, I was the only one that voted for it, so I'll make the motion to have him do the free part.
I'll second that.
To have a motion to what?
Do the free first part.
Let's do the feasibility study.
Yes.
Instead of coming out and addressing it.
Well, when I spoke with him, he said he would not do that, that they would come do the, he changed his mind the last month. But when I spoke to him, based on the phone calls and things he had said, was that he asked to be written up by council. And they would do the study, and then he told me he may not even have answers. All it is whether or not they would want to go in that direction.
And that's exactly what I heard
right. When
I talked to him.
It would be good to understand that, because I know from my previous experience that there are pipes in the ground here that we're going to be facing some major costs in the future if we don't call them in anyway. So it'd be good to know what we're facing. If they don't want to touch it, you know we're in for trouble.
Okay, we have a motion made and second for a feasibility study. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion passed. I also would like somebody to make a motion to give me authority to invite Mr. Brandt out for like the 19th of May council meeting.
I make said motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion on that?
Thank you.
Motion made and second. Aye in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion passed. I will invite Mr. Brandt out and try to get him here for the 19th of April. Any other citizens' comments? Need a motion to adjourn the meeting.
I'll make the motion to adjourn.
I second.
Discussion? Motion carried.
Hey, want to go get a beer?
No.
No? No beer?
Little Taco Tuesday, man. La Hacienda.
Well, not that. Excuse me, Woody, I can't hear.
Sorry.
I got a pass tonight.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. So the one trailer's still over there on Sticky Mountain Place. I want to apologize to you for not having that addressed yet, but I will. So, but that will be addressed. I've been gone. I had to take a couple of days.
You know, I don't blame you. I blame them.
Right. But and you know what? This year for you, whether you
out of professional respect, I have not sent that, made that 911 call. Okay? And I even said that once to Rob when he was here. I was going to make a 911 call, but I respected him too much in his time. But it is, it just, it wouldn't, it's not fair to get that RV guy and then leave the other ones. Because one of the things when I was on the council, my goal was that it would be evenly enforced. Not just, but I don't want to waste your time.
Well, the one over here on 3rd, Evergreen District Court issued a ruling on one that we dealt with a few years ago. That, because although it's in the right-of-way, it's still on his property.
Well, it's not. And so, it's on the right-of-way. How can it be on both?
The right-of-way passes through your property. You own it, but the right-of-way passes through it. And so, because the right-of-way is 60 feet wide, but the
66,
street is
66.
So what the court ruled was that
I'd like to see that.
So I don't have his ruling, and so I'm going based on my memory, and so that's what I'm telling you.
Because the city law.
So the issue was that if they're parking it, you know, in front of their own house, it's well off the traveled street, it's not creating a safety hazard, and it's currently licensed, that we couldn't impound them, and the court stuck the county with the impound fees, and then the guy got to put his trailer right back where he had it. Now, since then, at that time, actually, there was no thing about currently licensed. The state addressed that since then. But what the state addressed was simply, they said, okay, those vehicles have to be licensed. You can't park anything in the right.